Hello there, and welcome to episode 104 here at beautiful Behind the Bunker Studios here in gorgeous Burbank, California. My name is Todd Ansich, guys, and I am your host for this evening, and I have a ton of things on the show tonight. We have tonight's topic is ramping full auto or 3-pound burst? Is it even necessary? We also have another shit I should have sold while I had the chance, possibly another two squirts if we get the time, and we got videos from Skeletor, Joker, Snarky, Colonel Mustard, 300 FPS, Bowtie Bandits, J-Hub, Track 21, and many, many more. Who are you?
I am Josh Zuby Zabrickis. I will be bringing you paintball around the world this evening, as well as the segment On the Road Again to find out where Behind the Bunker and all of its correspondents will be.
Here I am!
On the Road Again. And
you gotta sing that.
We'll be posting up lots of videos from Paintball Extravaganza, the sneak peeks of the stuff that came out this past week. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Joe from Flag Raiders Paintball. Tonight we have lots of gear on Custom Corner. Each week we ask for submissions of custom gear, modified stuff to be sent in. I have a vault segment. I believe I have some of Jim Lively's personal vault items. And we have some great segments from Tom the Tom Tom Cat Cunningham from the Cat Shack Reports. And we have a feature on Team Feature and a whole cookie jar full of stuff on Behind the Bunker.
Very good. Now, sadly, Tomcat is not in the studio tonight. We don't have anybody on the couch because we have so many other things of goodness that we want to show you tonight, so we didn't want to have people come in and not be able to get to them tonight. But in the production booth, we have Dustin Schnitzelholst. Yes, you can see his mustache is still there, even though he promised us it would be gone by
soon,
now.
Soon. I don't think that's going anywhere.
No. And then we have Matt the Crypt pushing buttons. And we have Chris Christofferson, our intern. As well as now he's got his diploma and he's now our social media fellow.
Social media brand development strategist.
So what that means, guys, is we are watching our Twitter feed. If you have anything to say to the show or about what we're talking about, Chris is watching our Twitter feed tonight and we'll get your comments on the show. Tonight's show, guys, is brought to us by Empire Paintball, Air Ups Bunkers, Valken Paintball, Dye Paintball, Patchworks.
Yes, thanks.
And we also have a new sponsor tonight. Welcome, Titman. Titman has been watching us for a little while and has decided to come on board and be a part of this train wreck. So good for them. It's about time they make a bad mistake, and this is the decision that they've chosen. So good for them. They're with us for a little while. Tonight's topic that they're going to be bringing us is the vault.
Oh, very nice, the Titman vault.
Very nice.
Dennis Titman, Jr. or Sr. may be in the vault someday.
How fitting. So as we mentioned, tonight's topic is three-round burst ramping in full auto, and even necessary in paintball. And we've got lots of videos and lots of comments on our Facebook page that you guys have talked about. So we're gonna talk about that tonight and bring up some of that. So if you posted those up, your comment may be read. But why don't we get moving on? We've got a lot of videos to get to tonight. So why don't we get to our first video, and we'll be right back. Guys, Todd Ansich here, back for another edition of Shit I Should Have Sold While I Had the Chance. Paintball guns. We bring them in every week. We have them on the wall. Sometimes they sit for a little bit longer than most. Sometimes they sit around forever. Much like this one. This is the Evil Holtman. Never heard of it? I'm not surprised. This came out many years ago. This was Evil's first foray into the electrical marker genre. Neat gun, neat principle. Did not sell very well. We still have a few of these left over in our shop, so if you want one or are interested, get a hold of me. But check these out, guys. It's the Evil Omen. Not available now at any of your other finer stores. All right, very good. Now, we were at Paintball Extravaganza. Josh, Joe, myself, Matt, we were all down there last week, and we had a great live show, live from what was going to be inside the trade show, but we decided to do out in the Piano Bar Lounge, and it worked out really well. So check it out. Go to our YouTube channel, guys. It is up there right now. I know several thousand of you have already watched it, but you know what? There's too much paintball goodness there, too many new things for you not to check this out. If you were a paintball player, you should definitely be watching out. Plus, we also go through a lot of Zuby's diet for the last week, and you'd be surprised to see what went through Zuby last week. Yeah. Now, a couple of pictures I want to show you from Extravaganza.
Here is a picture of Joe and I with Mark Pagan.
Pagan.
Very good.
From Live Long Keep and Paintball Alive.
There's Mark Pagan in the middle, as well as Skeletor.
And Drake.
It's 50 Cent.
Is it?
No. That's the Akimbo Assassin right there. So check him out. Who else do we have?
Skeletor.
It was good to see everybody in person, that's for sure. Now this is me and Travis Lemansky, we're doing a video on the Vanquish, and everybody should be looking at the Vanquish, but instead Travis is so tired of looking at it, he was checking me out. Look at that, he's treating me like a piece of meat. I don't know if I enjoy that, Travis. And there, that is what I want to show you. This is my most prized possession from the event. This is the 2013 Otto Cocker Resurrection.
Resurrection. Possession?
Well, it was you in my hand at that yet. Point in
yeah.
time.
Okay, you touched it.
Shh, they don't
did
know.
You get to touch the black one?
I did.
I did.
Here's a quick picture. This is a gentleman who has his jersey designed by Animal Paintball. And as you can see on his arm, he has the Behind the Bunker logo. Very, very nice. And there's a two other ones here, misspelled. You can see his jersey that he had created, Behind the Bunker logo on the front and on the Ooh. Backside. I could almost say the backside's nicer. Now, this is Sarah Budson. You can see this is how they watched last week's Behind the Bunker on their way to Extravaganza. I just had to show that picture. If you guys are destined to watch the show and want to watch it and you can't figure it out, there's lots of ways you can watch it on your iPhone, via YouTube or live. If you want to go to Ustream, there's an app. It's very easy to download, and you can watch us right now live as you're traveling, as they did. Oh, look at this monster truck we're sponsoring. Behind the Bunker. Fantastic. Awesome. If you guys want stickers much like these, drop me an email and I will send some to you in the mail. All you need to do is send me a self-addressed stamped envelope and we'll cram them full of stickers for you. Why don't we give our intern... Oh, this. Zuby's new gun. This is what he found exciting at the paintball explosion or extravaganza. This is... Remember what these are called? Oh, exploders. You can grow your own paintballs. But what did it say on the front of the box? Remember? It said it was safe with a big check mark, safety tested. But then right beside it, it says,
oh, yeah,
do not shoot at face.
Do not aim at eyes or face.
Very good. Maybe one day we'll be able to grow our own paintballs. But in the meantime, not a very good product. That's it for the pictures I wanted to show you. Why don't we give our intern / social media expert some love?
It was actually Target.
Good evening, everyone. It's Chris Christofferson with your weekly tidbits. First one comes to us from Shoreline Paintball. They're announcing their Stargate Big Game. It's always been the UK's most loved paintball festival, but this year it's been put on steroids. The introduction of the CPPS Summer Fair brings SUP Air to Stargate for the first time, and the inclusion of the UWL Super Cup also brings Woodland Tournament to what is already a fantastic big game festival weekend. Now at Stargate, there is something for everyone. SUP Air, Woodland Tournament, Scenario, Big Game, all at one event on one weekend and topped off with plenty of partying with your mates. This is what paintball is all about, and that is from September 14th to the 15th, 2013.
Very good.
And
fantastic.
Where?
And that one was at Shoreline Outdoor.
Very cool. Before Chris moves on, I want to say welcome to Scuba in the chat forum from the Northern Gunmen. Nice to see you in the chat forum. And we'll be looking forward to seeing you at Canadian Carnage this year at Flag Raiders Paintball on...
June 15th, Saturday.
Watch for more info as it gets released. That was my social media.
Excellent. We're also
very social media.
Poster's coming. All right, would you like another one or would you like me to say...
Do you want to share more tidbits or should we wait?
I can give you one more tidbit. This one is for immediate release. We have a Super Game 45 raffle to benefit the Teen Challenge of Oregon. Dan Bonebreak of Super Games announced today that the Bryce Hodgkins Memorial Raffle, hosted May 3rd through the 5th, 2013 at Super Game 45, will benefit the Teen Challenge of Oregon. Tim Bryce Hodgkiss Memorial Raffle is named for player Bryce Hodgkiss, who passed away shortly after Super Game in 2010. Twice each year, sponsors of the Super Game donate over 25,000 in prizes, products, and services to be raffled in remembrance of Bryce's life and to benefit local charitable organizations and family in need. Teen Challenges of Oregon provides recovery services for young people wanting to overcome addiction. Begun in 1958, Teen Challenge has assisted millions of teens and young adults to rebuild their lives as they overcome their dependencies on drugs or alcohol. Super Game 45 is a three-day paintball big game and industry trade show held in St. Paul, Oregon. Super Game has grown to attract over 1,000 players to its spring event. In addition to 3 days of paintball, camping, entertainment, and shopping, Super Game focuses on family connection and community outreach. For more information about the Bryce Hodgkiss Memorial Raffle or Teen Challenge, please contact Don Bonebreak, www.supergame.tv.
Very cool. Also want to point out a couple people in the chat forum. I want to say hello to Yannick. We had a chance to meet Yannick for the first time in person last week at Paintball Extravaganza. Yannick comes to us all the way from
Poland.
I also want to say welcome to whoever in the chat forum that's called Outdoor Season is Approaching, because yes, it is just around the corner.
As soon as the snow melts.
Despite the fact that you won't be able to tell that from last weekend when we were at Red Dawn, there was more snow than we knew what to do with, but fantastic day.
We should send a shout out to Cupcake as well, my bearded brother himself.
Very good. So, Joe, every week you ask people to send in pictures of themselves playing.
Action shots.
With themselves.
I do have some action shots. Our first one, I have to put on my glasses because I've alleviated your font problem. Okay, our first one, Matt.
Dude, smaller.
This is a picture of Ethan and Adam Havoc. They're playing somewhere in Ontario. You can see by the snow and the cement blocks. The cement blocks are used to keep polar bears out of people's encampments. They're not sure if we want more information, but that is a pretty good amount of information, and we thank you very much for your submission.
It's also number 99.
It's 99. Our next picture is of Kelly Brennan playing paintball in her Vulcan E-Tax camouflage, officially licensed product, and her pink Sly mask, and note the pink behind the bunker sticker. Very nice.
Super limited.
Next, from Joseph Lautner. We have two images of him playing paintball. He's also made a submission for Custom Corner, which we'll touch on later, and he's in Bowling Springs, North Carolina. There he is there. That is the deer in the headlights look from our friend Joseph Lautner. Number four comes to us from Sean, who's playing paintball at his local field. The next one is of him at EMR Castle Conquest as he's attacking a castle. And he's holding down a bunker at the Home Field War Club Paintball Park. So those are our submissions today for action shots. So if anybody has any pictures of themselves playing paintball or their friends playing paintball, please send it to show@behindthebunker.com with a little bit of information, where you're playing, your name, maybe who you're playing with, et cetera, et cetera, and we'll get it up on the show. So that's for action shots.
For sure. Pew, pew. We just had a question brought in on our Twitter feed from Brandon Caudill, wondering if we are monitoring the Ustream chat. We will try and do our best to get on there, but we right now are monitoring the chat that's on the Behind the Bunker website, as well as Twitter and our Facebook feed. So we will do our best, but if you're watching us on Ustream, jump on over to www.behindthebunker.com, and that's where all the interactive chats and feeds are. So come on over and join us if you like what you
chatty.
See. Yeah, if you like what you see. Why don't we move on tonight? Tonight's topic again is ramping, three-round burst, or
are you
full
a pirate?
Auto. Arr. I should have brought my patch.
Yes.
So our topic tonight is these modes even necessary? So what we're going to do is we went and asked all of our correspondents, and most of them sent in videos. And this is Clint from 300FPS. Let's see what he has to say.
Hey everyone, this week we're talking about, is ramping, full auto, or three round burst even necessary in paintball? Personally, I don't think so. That's my personal opinion. I think ramping, I don't know what it really does for the sport. It's not much trigger control. I think it takes a little bit of the skill out of the game. I think the way triggers are designed on the electro guns now that they're using, if you move your fingers fast enough, it's going to go fast anyway. So I don't know what ramping really does. Three-round burst, maybe in a different scenario, like a woods ball game or some kind of something like that. But personally, for me, I don't see the use for it. I don't think it does anything for the game. It wastes a lot of paint. If you have a lot of money to waste on paint, then I guess go for it. But not for me. It's just not for me. But, you know, I'm just kind of bummed. This week was Paintball Extravaganza, and I couldn't make it. And I saw the pictures online, and I wish I could have gone. I would have visited a few of my favorite booths. Hey, Bob, did you bring my VCOM?
This is Tom Cotkin Cunningham from the Catcher Reports, here at Next Paintball with a whole bunch of baccarats. And keep watching Behind the Bunker. Peace out.
Really, George?
But get it right, George.
All right, welcome back. Behind the Bunker is on the road. We are between us that's in the panel and our correspondents. We will be at many events this year, so I'm just going to go through a few of them real quick. PRZ, April 13th and 14th, you're going to see Tomcat, Zuby, Hazard, Colonel Mustard, and quite a few more. Maybe if I get a chance, I will get out there myself as well. Depends on if I get a handwritten invite in calligraphy. We also have Paint Fest, April 28th, coming up.
You might want to tell them where we're going.
I said PRZ.
PRZ.
Okay. Yeah. I'm so sorry, I didn't hear it.
Zuby tunes in and out depending on...
Then you said in Caligula, that movie.
Oh, I said in conjunction?
No, I'm just kidding.
So Paint Fest, guys, April 28th at Flaggers Paintball, as well as D-Day, May 26th at Flaggers Paintball. You'll see us. You'll also see us at Living Legends in Chicago for the Living Legends 6. I'm not sure if we've decided which team we're going to be on, but most likely we'll be playing with...
a paintball team.
Hoo-yah!
Probably.
Wolf.
Yeah. As well as this Canadian X-Ball... League, the XBL will be at Flaggers Paintball as well in June 9th and 10th. If you guys are not playing in that league and want to check out some really good Canadian paintball, that's definitely something you should check out.
Are we doing the barbecue again?
I think so.
Probably.
Yeah. Yes.
So yeah. I will be there running the barbecue.
Awesome.
He'll be all hot and sweaty and grease will be dripping off and hamburger juice
really
all
matters,
over him.
Right?
If you want to see Zuby smelling like meat, come to the CXBL event and get yourself a hot dog or see his sausages. If you'd like to see Zuby sausages. All right, so we're going to move on since we butchered that section.
Yes, we did.
So again, tonight's topic is, what is three-round burst or fire, any of these firing modes, even necessary when you play paintball? Well, why don't we head on down to North Carolina and ask our friend Colonel Mustard.
How's it going, guys? Colonel Mustard here. Today's topic is, are firing modes necessary, i.e. ramp, three-shot burst, full auto, etc.? I personally don't use firing modes. I actually leave my marker on semi-auto only, but it's also an electronic marker and my fingers can move whatever the requirement is for the field. In rec play, I don't think that firing modes are necessary. I think that semi-auto is fine. My local field uses semi-auto only and it doesn't seem to be an issue. Everybody seems to be able to eliminate people still, so I don't think you need the extra rounds. In speedball, I do think that it makes sense to have firing modes. If nothing else, a ramp or a three-shot burst, because it's just a lot easier for people coming in to get up to speed on their shooting if they can ramp and if they can do three-shot bursts, as opposed to having to train their fingers. With that being said, I think that you're better off if you train your fingers because you have more trigger control than if you use a three-shot burst or a ramp, because sometimes guns continue to ramp or continue to burst when you don't mean to keep shooting and you have to literally take your barrel off of the target. So that's my opinion. It's kind of mixed, but that's what I got for you. Talk to you guys later. What's up, guys? Today's topic is our firing round.
Bang! Just not a handsome fellow.
I
believe this photo is in response to he posted up something that Empire sent him a bunch of gear. So I posted up a bathroom mirror duck face photo, or you know, the lie, and that's what he posted up. Which I believe, if Wikipedia is correct, Colonel Mustard is actually the inventor of the duck face.
Yes, so, you heard it here.
But, yeah.
Now, also according to his video, he enjoys training his fingers. Good for him. Train your fingers. Why don't we move on, guys, to our next segment, and we'll be right back.
Custom Corner is brought to you by the Dam Die Assault Matrix.
I wanted a gun that would cover everything. I want to be able to hold off 30, 40, 50 guys coming at me. I want to be able to crawl up and take snipe shots on guys. I want, you know, you need a gun that's very diverse and could cover all the different angles. So they came up with this new gun called the Dam.
All right, here we are, guys. Each week I ask for submissions, I can't see, from you, the viewer, to send in any modifications, things you've tricked out, modified, painted, done to, to your markers, masks, hoppers, anything like that, camouflage, if you made a ghillie suit, send it in to showitbehindabunker.com.
I would like to see custom 12 grams. We haven't seen a custom 12
grams. Maybe Jazz can hydro dip some 12 grams. We challenge you, Jazz. All right, here's our first one. This comes to us from Choke R. Ward. This is his 98C Winter Series. Belongs to Lewis, a.k.a. Bushmaster, from Danger Close Milson Paintball. He's out of Ottawa, Ontario, Canada's nation's capital. He has a 16-round Helix feed neck, an offset rail for his 50mm red dot sight, the bounty shroud with sound-dampening foam silencer, a CAA cheek weld, angled butt plate, sounds nice, covered bolt cocking lever, reduced trigger pull, so the spring, he's got a spring mod, polished internals, a bipod, and a milled out breech to accept first strike rounds. He's got a 14-inch Smart Parts progressive barrel. Nice job. And he's wearing a white ghillie suit, and he has no top sheet at home. He only has the fitted sheet now.
Can you go back a picture for a second?
Back
I just one. Wanna, Zuby and I are trying to figure that out. Okay, so it is his feed stack. He needs a little purple pill for that.
It's a little...
Looks like it's falling down.
Which now, according to the commercial on the radio, is just as much as the generic brand.
I've heard that today.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
So moving right along. Okay, you guys are trying to derail my segment. This comes to us from Cameron Vanavong from Cambridge, Ontario, Canada, North America, Earth. He's at Red Dawn 8, and he's got a stock bipod, a laser, 20 parts, and a 20mm red dot sight on his paintball marker. Nice job, Cameron. So he took that and submitted it yesterday. Good Very job. Nice. Our next one comes to us from Joseph Lauder, again from Bowling Springs, South Carolina. It's a couple pictures of his Phantom pump with a custom violin case. I was going to say violation.
That's super cool.
Case, and some action shots of him playing paintball. This is at his home field, Line of Fire in Henderson, North Carolina. Awesome. Very cool. I like the violin case. It's a nice, very, very nice
very
touch.
Very gangsta.
It is very gangster, very prohibitionish.
True
early,
gangster.
Early 1900s.
True gangster.
Chicago style prohibition. This comes to us from Sean, maybe Bolton, and it's his version 2 invert mini. Not too much done to it, but some custom paint, a drop forward, and a foregrip extension. So nice work, and he's got some, it looks like he's using Eclipse gear, I-4 and a Vulcan loader. No? Maybe, yeah.
It's a rotor with a Vulcan sticker. He has a little bit of everything going on there. He has an Eclipse jersey. And
he does. He's got a helmet.
I
like it on his couchouflage.
Mm-hmm.
And our next one comes to us from TZB Smash. It's his E-Tech Pinocchio loader, Freak Barrel. It's got an R7 mount, a Die I-4. It's got a Guru gun stand. So nice job. Thank you very much. And some balls sprinkled liberally on his floor. Listen to the way my bell resonates. And our next one is a video from Todd, who's there. And he does each week he modifies or customizes the Die Assault Matrix and submits it to show it behind the bunker. We accept it each week from him because we feel sorry because even his mom says he's handsome. So we're going to look at Todd's customized video of the damn Die Assault Matrix and we'll see what he's done this week.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich here, back for another edition of Custom Corner. Every week on Custom Corner, I take my Die Assault Matrix and I change it so that you can not only play it with a different, but it also looked different. This week I thought I'd try something a little bit different. Last week we did a super long sniper rifle. This week we thought we'd go bare bones. I stripped everything down. We added a 1-point bungee sling, which is attached to the Picatinny rail that runs the whole length of the gun. We took off one of the shrouds, put a very small barrel on it. And because the only ammunition I'm taking is my mag, I'm going to take the longest one, so I have 20 rounds in here. So nice and small, I don't have to hold on to it, I can use the sling as I'm carrying it, but as you can see, nothing to encumber me, nice and small, nice and light, can play CQB, could play out in the bush, doesn't matter, but check that out, doesn't that look pretty badass? I like that very much. So check it out guys, every week I take my Die Assault Matrix and I make it look different, so that it will not only play different, but it looks different. See you guys next week.
Hey everybody, Tomcat Cunningham with the Catch Tech Sports Paintball News, and we're still down here at sea.
I'm Les Stroud, also known as Survivor Man. You're watching the Catch Tech Reports on BehindTheBunker.com. Keep watching.
Hey everybody, Tomcat Cunningham with the Catch Tech Sports Paintball News, back for another exciting edition of Behind the Bunker again this week. Today, we're coming at you from next paintball in Pickering in the Toronto area. It is a pretty cool indoor. We're down here today to celebrate a member of Team Makara's birthday. So we're out here and we're doing a little paintball for somebody's birthday. Very cool stuff. In this week's news, free, free, free. What is better than free? Reed Patchwork this year. He is currently running a bit of a promotion. If you place an order for three or more patches from Patchwork, you will get a free patch of your choice. You will get a second free patch that is a bit of a surprise for a wristband. Or you can have free shipping worldwide as well. So very good from Patchwork. Also in the news this week, PSP has issued a lot of news with everything from their layout for the PSP season to some rule changes for 2013, so be sure to check that out on the Catch Tech Sports Paintball News. And there was a lot of different things that came out of the very recent paintball extravaganza, as far as the wrap-up and a bunch of products. The ones to watch, I think, would be the Empire Autococker, the Bob Bone VCOM, and of course the Vanguard Demon. Very cool markers coming out of the paintball extravaganza, which you've already seen them behind the bunker. According to sources, the big show had a lot of people in attendance this year, and it is showing signs for a much healthier marketplace for paintball. So very good.
Watching Behind the Bunker.
That one gets me every time. That is like my new favorite one. Yes.
That was a good one.
We had an opportunity to hang with Skeletor and a lot of the guys in the crew that came, A-Train, awesome. And all the people from Mad Frog. I'm not going to mention everybody, but it was a great week at Paintball Extravaganza. If you have an opportunity to get there, I would highly recommend it.
It's kind of tiring.
It's very exhausting, you know, all those late sleeping mornings and early to bed. Yeah. Chris is giving us the violin. All right, guys, so tonight's topic is, are these burst modes and ramping modes even necessary when you play paintball? I know Joe and Zuby and I all have a comment, and we will get to those, but let's check out Misspelled and see what he has to say.
Hey, everybody. This week's question on Behind the Bunker asks, is ramping, three-round burst, full auto even needed? Needed, most of the times, no. Is it fun? Yeah. When using those modes, the biggest thing for me is having trigger discipline and understanding what's going on while you're firing. If you're shooting down a lane of 15 rounds a second, that should only be used if you're trying to cover somebody or keep someone pinned. Otherwise, if you've got a clear shot on the person or you can get a clear shot on the person, take one, two, maybe three shots. See if you hit. If you don't, try again. That way you're not lighting someone up and bonus balling them. So again, it's one of those situational things.
Question Time is brought to you by Arabs.
No, when you have an Arabs bucker, you don't hear the noise. No,
it's up.
It certainly is. Dustin, every week people send in us questions via Facebook, via Twitter, via email to show up behind the bunker, and Dustin grabs them, prints them, brings them into the show.
Dustin, you match nicely.
I do.
Your red toque. And your red...
Red, the good.
Yeah, no, it's a good
one. And for those of you that are watching outside Canada, hat. Red hat.
Swag.
Red hat.
All right. My first question tonight here is from Dan Valanza. He's wondering, what do you guys use when you play? Do you guys prefer a vest or a pod pack?
That's a good question. Everybody plays differently and has different playing styles. Chris, what do you play with, Mr. Intern? And how often do you play with it?
When I play, which is not super often, but a couple of times a year at least, I use a vest. I still have my original Spec Ops broadsword, which I bought in 2004 when I started working for Flag Raiders, and it's got everything that I need in it. It fit, and it still fits now, so I can't complain. It keeps all the paint on my back and all the tools on my front. That's it. What more can I say, man? I love it.
That was good.
Yeah.
Good, best question.
Now, this question is actually something that we're going to be doing and covering on our show in a couple of weeks. So I think we're going to leave Joe, Josh, and myself to not answer that question, just so that we can not give it away for the next show. I think it's coming up in 2 weeks, that show. Dustin, though, we'll ask you, what do you play with? I know you were out yesterday playing the Winter Big Game.
Yeah, I was out yesterday playing the big game. I shot a Lux. I shot pretty good.
A what? A Lux?
A Lux. The D-Lux. It shot pretty good, and I use a pod pack. I use a 4 plus 7, but I only take 4 pods on the field.
That's all you had?
Yeah, there's playing with a 3 pod pack, I don't like it. It's, you don't have as enough pods, I find, and it's not as comfortable as a 4 plus.
Yeah, you need those plethora of pods.
Yeah.
Yeah, do you have another question before we...
I do. I have a good one here from PCAM. His call sign and his actual name is Clinton Meyer. He's wondering, or he basically, I have a question.
So you're related to Oscar?
Maybe. Makes hot dogs?
Yes.
His email reads, I have a question for Question Time. A member of my team refuses to play woods ball. He only will play speedball and argues that there's nothing that he can learn or that can be gained from playing woods ball to help the speedball game. However, he believes that playing speedball can improve your woods ball performance. I believe that both game formats can complement each other in making you a better player. What do you guys think?
Kick him off your team.
That question's been asked last week, or 2 weeks ago.
I think speedball is like white wine when you go to a wedding. They have to put it on the table, but no one ever drinks it.
you know what? I'm gonna seriously answer that question because I think it's a really good one. I think both formats, you know, you can take the world's greatest speedballer and put him out playing woods ball, but he's not going to be the best woods ball player. There's so many more dynamics when you're playing in the bush, or when you're playing with buildings, when you're not playing with your teammates, and when you're playing against 100 people. You can even have five of your teammates from your speedball team out there, and it's not gonna go the way you want it to go. I'm not gonna say you're gonna get your yourself handed to yourself, but it's certainly a different genre. Much like a woods ball player can go onto a speedball field and play and be competitive because it is still paintball, but the guys that play on those speedball fields every week know, you know, how to move, how to operate on that field. Now, one thing I will say is speedball players do definitely do more skills and drills, and that you can argue maybe makes them better, maybe, but in that specific genre for sure. But I don't know. I'm going to leave it at that because I'm sure we can.
I'd just like to say that his friend is what we call very close-minded, which is typical speedballer-ish. So.
Spoken like a perfect woods baller.
Woods baller.
Yeah, I'm playing the woods.
Yep. Well, why don't we move on, guys? Up next, we have a video from The Wolf. Ooh, yeah.
Welcome to Behind the Bunker. Today's topic is firing modes. Are you for or against, like, three-round burst, full auto, yada, yada, yada? Very interesting subject. Personally, here's my thoughts. I am a Milsom player. I am a woods ball player. The reason why I love playing this game is because of the simulated combat, the simulated military tactics, the simulation of that type of world is what attracts me to this game. In the world of speedball, semi-auto, maybe ramping, perfect. But in the world of woods ball, Milsom scenario, I think the more firing modes, the better. Three-round burst, full auto, I love it all because it's supposed to simulate battle. And in battle, you have all different types of ranges, all different types of markers or guns or whatever you call it. We even have rounds coming from Havocs. We have Nerf rounds going off, taking out buildings and tanks. Everything, almost anything, should be available as long as people are not getting hurt too much, I should say. You know, now we have first strike rounds. You know, are you going to start to limit those to what have you? First strike rounds should be limited to a certain distance, but I think they should still be allowed because in real Milsom combat, you have snipers who can shoot farther than regular shooters. So, if you're up to me, especially for woods ball scenario, I say let it all in. The more the merrier. It gives me more of a challenge. I have to duck my head more. I like it. If you want to spend that much paint, feel free. If you want to play pump, feel free. Leave it open. Oh yeah, see you next time behind the bunker. It's been a blast.
Very good. Nicely done, Wolf.
You did the music in that one, Todd.
A little, yeah. That was awesome. I'm pretty talented. I like his outro, but I thought I would make it a little more hip, a little more urban, a little more street, a little more ghetto. Yeah, that's all about me.
That's nice.
So, Todd.
Chris.
Delta Knight has tweeted us on Twitter and wants to say congrats at Behind the Bunker for Tippmann sponsoring. Live the show watching right now. Keep up the awesome entertainment. And if you guys have an opinion on tonight's topic, make sure to get it up on Twitter, and I am looking for those replies right now.
Can I stop you for a second?
You absolutely
can. I know that's a fake Twitter because there's only 144 characters allowed, and that went on for like six paragraphs.
No, yeah,
that could have all have been the same Twitter.
It's right down to the wire.
Oh, those Delta Knights, those guys can count their characters.
They sure can. Guys, if you would like to be a part of this abomination that we call a paintball show, all you need to do is hook me up with an email, show@behindthebunker.com, and you can send me things like your general questions for the show, your team bio, we'd like to feature your team on the show, your custom gear picks for Joe and his custom corner, Zuby would like to go around the world with you, and get your event posters. Nominate a player of the week and send it in as well, and you'll get them on the air.
Around the world. Woo! Oh, that's a reach around.
Yeah, and this is a stop short. All right. And so if you would like to be a part of the show, definitely get a hold of us, guys. We are looking for weekly correspondents to send in their opinions as well, so we could do that. SM Headwear. We are giving away a headband very soon. All you need to do is go over to SM Headwear and post a pic on their Facebook page of yourself playing. That's it. And you are automatically entered in that fantastic draw for a custom Behind the Bunker headband.
Mm-hmm. Is it fantastic?
Fantastic.
Now you're just reaching for straws.
Now, guys, we were all out at Red Dawn at Flaggers yesterday for the winter big game. And we ran into a few other fellows aside from Wolf and Tomcat and all the rest. We found someone else who normally hibernates in the winter, and he wanted to put his opinion on tonight's topic. Check it out. This is Kaz from Visual Reviews.
Hey, what's going on? Kaz here from Visual Reviews. We're out here at Red Dawn. The question of the week for Behind the Bunker is, yes, I did fart. Is
that's not the question.
Three round or full auto necessary? I say hell yeah. You just gotta light fools up. Just light fools up. Just light them up. Goggles, face, Todd.
Hey guys, if you like what you see and would like to support the show, consider buying a support package. We have the standard support package, which includes a t-shirt, limited edition barrel bag, stickers, and limited run stickers. And we also have a deluxe support package for $44.99, which includes the 3D patch from our friends at Patchworks.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, thanks.
Patches. And if you have any extra change in the cushions at the bottom of the car, or you'd like to get your pennies in before they're gone, consider donating to our chip-in widget. And of course, guys, for all of our segments, as well as the videos that you see on the show tonight, be sure to check out our YouTube channel and like us on Twitter and Facebook.
What's up, guys? Joker here. This week's topic is three-round burst ramping in full auto necessary for paintball? Well, in my opinion, no, it's not. It's probably helpful in some scenarios, like speedball back players. Those guys could probably use it and it be helpful to them, but I still don't think it's a requirement. I actually have a Phenom, X7 Phenom, and I've had it since it came out and have never one time even installed a battery to use the full auto on it. I also use a tack cap, so it does. I do have a limited amount of paint. Full auto would probably deplete my paint supply and my hopper in an instant, practically. But it's very interesting that a lot of times we play with speedballers, our squad, when we play against them, They're in shock that we're able to put out just as many players as they are using their ramped up full auto guns, things like that. And we're able to put out just as many with selective fire and, you know, semi-automatic guns with limited paint. So is it a requirement? By no means at all. Is it helpful in some scenarios? Sure, but is it a requirement? I don't think so at all. You can have just as much success with just a single semi-automatic fire and do just as well in the field. So that's my opinion, guys. Take it easy.
Tomcat Cunningham with the Cat Shack Sports Paintball News. We are still down here at Next Paintball in Pickering in the Toronto area. And with me, I've got a whole bunch of backers. that right? You guys are all down here playing some paintball.
Yeah!
Hoorah! Why are we down here playing some paintball? I understand that it's somebody's birthday.
Oh, yes it is.
What better way to celebrate your birthday than a little paintball, am I right, boys?
Hoorah!
Alright, so this is Team Bakra, and you guys, there was a couple of these guys on the show there a couple weeks back there.
Got the sheriff.
We're down here at next paintball. Tomcat Cunningham with the Catch Jack Sports Paintball News, and you're watching
The Under!
Team feature is brought to you by Empire Paintball. If you are on a team or want to be on a team, if you are five or more players, you can get sponsored like a pro, whether you're a woods ball player, speedball player, scenario player. If you have five players, contact Key Action Sports and they will send your dossier to their local dealer, and their dealer will help you get set up through their dealer network all over North America.
Joe, what if I was a role player?
If you were a role player, depending whether you were what kind of role you were playing, you could still get sponsored like a pro or something like that.
Very nice.
Yes.
Chris.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do we have any more tidbits in the tidbittery?
We have one more tidbit. Nice. This one is quite exciting, and it comes from Huntington Beach, California. Mm. Registration for the 2013 NPPL Surf City USA Open in beautiful Huntington Beach, California is now open. Get ready to gear up for our greatest season yet. 2013 is going to be an exciting year as the NPPL kicks off our Super 7 World Series with the Surf City USA Open in Huntington Beach, April 12th, 13th, and 14th. The NPPL is back and stronger than ever with low entry fees and great prize packages that reward the teams in the biggest divisions while still encouraging teams to move up. Come experience what the NPPL has to offer. Be sure to register early as we do expect the Surf City USA Open will sell out fast like last year.
Very nice.
Nicely done.
Thank you. That was a little bit longer. It would have been more of more than a tidbit.
It was a one paragraph tidbit. Just fit.
Very now, eloquent. He may have gone to Huntington Beach, but I would like to go to South Africa. Why don't we see what our correspondent all the way from South Africa have to say about our topic this evening.
So, is ramping full auto on three-round burst even necessary?
Well, yeah! You gotta go three-round burst! You gotta go full auto! I mean, I'm still waiting for that strike loader backpack to come out. Or the Titman Hellhound to become available. I want the Hellhound.
Yeah, he just went over the audience's head with some of the Hellhound stuff.
Well, that's what the green screen's for.
Anyway. A better question would be, is semi-automatic even necessary?
Of course it's necessary.
It's not necessary. We used to play this game pump gun. Or bolt action.
Really?
Yeah, you're an idiot. Paintball can be played on a budget. You can play it limited. We don't need high rates of fire.
Yeah, well that sucks. I want to shoot fast.
And I'm Josh at Zoomies the Brickers. I'm bringing you lots of events for paintball around the world.
Paintball around the world is brought to you by Vulcan.
Welcome to Paintball Around the World. If you have a poster you'd like to send into the show, send it on into show@behindthebunker.com and we'll be sure to put it on the show for next week. If you throw the Behind the Bunker logo on there, we'll throw you a little bit of extra love. First poster we have up for tonight is the South Park Games. A Town Divided is happening April 28th. ExploreBrownCountry.com for more info. Alien vs. Predator vs. Marines is happening April 26th and 28th. And that's at LCP Scenario Games.
Where?
.com.
Not Behind the Bunker. Yes, thank you.
Animal Bunker Fest is coming up May 18th and 19th at San Antonio, Texas. And also, note, Behind the Bunker. And Blast Camp Chaos is coming up April 20th and 21st. And the Port Huron Big Game 11 is being held on June 8th. And the next Raiders Cup Series is happening March 24th, the indoor location, Gage Street in Kitchener, Ontario. You know the postal code, Joe?
I don't know the postal code.
Okay. I'll look. And Canadian Carnage is coming to Flag Raiders June 15th. That's this summer.
Yeah.
D-Day, Guns of Navarone, also going on at Flag Raiders, is happening May 26th. Note that, look at it, Behind the Bunker, Cat Shack, BT Rangers, Task Force Rangers, Tim and Empire.
Grid Productions.
Grid Productions, yes. And Bowser's Revenge is going on at Crazy Bill's Paintball April 21st. Fields of Fire Mystic is happening April 7th. It is going to be the Sox versus the Yankees. And yes, it is a paintball game.
If you build it, people will come.
Yes, if you build it, they will come. Fight for Asylum is happening April 13th through the 14th. It's the Behind the Bunker logoed game, as most of us will be there. And the Brotherhood Tour 2013 ODST and guests such as Sonny Lopez, Greg Hastings, Patrick Boulanger, and many more. Note the Behind the Bunker logo.
Hey!
Yay! Let's all come together to look at this poster for a little while longer. It's happening September 14th and 15th. It's the Shoreline Outdoor Game.
That sucks.
ODX Top Sniper Challenge is coming up April 7th.
Oh.
Yeah. And possibly the best Behind the Bunker cameo picture we have is an extreme paintball for Guns for Hoses.
My favorite
poster. May 5th. Yes. And Living Legends 6 is going down at CPX on May 17th through till 19th. And Dead Man's Hand, Battlefield Rush, June 9th at Long Live Paintball.
I believe that's Ron versus Mary.
Is it Ron versus, yeah,
it is.
Yeah. And Embrace the Battle, 2013 Generals Cup is happening April 13th and 14th. GeneralsCup.com for more info. And Black Hawk Down, Mogadishu Mile, September 22nd at Flag Raiders. Again, Behind the Bunker, Catchack, Empire, Tipman, Task Force Raiders, Juniors, BT Rangers, and the Grid Production. OXCC Sedition is going on March 16th at the Outdoor Extreme, Chesapeake City Field, Maryland. And Red Dawn Part 2 Occupation is happening April 20th and 21st. First at the D-Day Adventure Park. Vulcan Cup is coming up 2013. And last but not least, we have the Super Game 45 going down to St. Paul, Oregon. Note Behind the Bunker logo. And I do believe that Clint in 300 FPS will be there.
The Vault is brought to you by Tipman Sports.
Looking to kick your woods ball or scenario play up a notch? The True Military Style TIPX pistol is compact, lightweight, accurate, and packed with features you'll love. It can be used on its own or as a sidearm to add a new dimension to any game. The underbarrel 12-gram CO2 system is easy to load and activated with the first pull of the trigger. That means it's primed and ready to go when you are. And since the CO2 is separate from the 7-ball magazine, extra magazines come at a great price. They come in handy with the efficient spool valve system that keeps the paint moving. This pistol features an underbarrel Picatinny rail and a removable barrel with X7 threads, leaving you plenty of options to customize. You can even add a remote line. You'll find plenty of accessories as well, like the thigh holster that's friendly to righties and southpaws alike. Remember, the TIPX pistol features Tippmann's 2-year warranty and is backed by their industry-leading customer service support. The TIPX pistol is a great solo marker or tactical backup for your game.
Hi guys, Joe from Flag Raiders Paintball. We're here at Paintball Extravaganza, and I've had access to Jim Lively's personal vault. What I have to show you is the official Survival Game Air Gun Manual. This is a second printing. It's been signed by Bob Guernsey, so he's the person that started this, or as the JT t-shirt goes, paintball ruined my life. But it wasn't paintball then, it was war games. Then the Americans called it splatball. Then it became adventure games. Now it's paintball. This is a second printing. This is circa 1988. So it's got some vintage. It's very, very vault worthy. It's a brand new book. It's been unopened. It has full game explanations of team and individual games, best strategies for winning, rules for casual and championship play. Very nice. Equipment and playing fields, history of the game. 1987, there wasn't a whole lot of history. Some guys were playing paintball with oil-based paintballs, and you'd have to go home and clean up with Varsol before you were finished. And you wouldn't have to worry about cleaning your paintball gear because you didn't have any, and you would just put your goggles or your safety glasses in the sink to clean them with some dishwashing soap. Other than that, pretty cool, a little bit of strategy tips. So this is a 200-page volume from the National Survival Game. They were one of the largest franchisers of paintball fields in the world at the time. Now they're not here, but thanks guys, this is what started it. Thanks to Jim Lively for letting me in the vault. Joe from Flag Raiders, see you next time.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah, not only did he let him in his vault, but he's also in Jim Lively's friend circle of trust, so.
Very nice.
In the friend zone. And if you watch next week, here's a teaser, you will see yet another
Jim Lively,
circa
1986. You missed the anyone that saw the Tippmann video, the little commercial. They also have an olive green TIPX pistol.
We debuted that this week, didn't we?
We debuted, which they released at Extravaganza. So super cool.
Very good.
Black, tan, and olive.
Or the ones they're selling in Mexico, the pistoles.
Yeah.
Very nice. Very
it's
nice.
Italy.
Italy.
But close.
What?
Same thing. Italian, Spanish, same thing, right?
That was like this close to slow clap worthy.
It was. That's why I kept talking. I didn't want to get the slow clap in there. All right, let's keep going. Dustin, do you have a question?
Yes.
I do have a question here. I have a question here from Mike Henderson. He's wondering, what do you guys do when your gun goes down in the middle of a firefight?
Scream like that's a good girl. Point.
Well, typically I'm using an Empire sniper, so the gun, in order for the gun to go down, there's really not much to... I mean, I might get a ball jam. I pull my bolt out. I cram a squeegee through it.
Ew.
Clean it out. That's about it.
So rough.
I mean, or if I'm playing with the dam, if I get a ball jam, I usually just switch over to MagFed or to Hopper, and it clears that out pretty nice. But if my gun ultimately cannot work and doesn't work, why one off the field? Why not just either become a guy who runs for the flag, or at least
a leader,
help motivate and move people along?
Tony Robbins.
Yeah, for sure. Sometimes though, if you're near an exit, if you're near the edge of the field and it's a big game, it's sometimes faster just to get off the field, fix your gun, and come back to it.
Or grab another one.
Yeah, for sure. Or punch a rental kid and take his gun.
That's nice.
Some
kid having his birthday party.
For God sure.
Takes, like to beat up 10-year-olds having their birthday party.
Now, Chris, you've got one more tidbit left in the tidbit vault. And this is like something that you, well, maybe a quick explanation of what this is, and we'll see what happens.
This was sent in to us, and I mean, I don't even really know if I want to play it. It's...
Let's see if it's tidbit worthy. What is it?
Let's give it... Let's see what you guys think. Let's take a look. Alright guys, so that was sent in from Dynasty.
I just spilled my white wine.
I guess they had to just jump on the bandwagon with everybody else. I know we're all sick of it, but tell me what you think. Hit me up on Twitter, leave a comment on Facebook, or hit us up in the chat room.
For sure. Why don't we move on, guys? Tonight's topic again is our three-round burst ramping or modes or full auto, even necessary on the paintball field. Well, with her opinion, this is J-Hub back at Behind the Bunker.
Hey, J-Hub here coming at you from Old River Paintball. Stop and think where we are. Out here with Behind the Bunkers and Miss Belled and Barbara and Kelly. Everybody's out here having a good time, shooting people up, getting shot, of course. No, not really, but yeah. What was the question of the week this week, Miss Belled?
Is ramping full auto or three-round burst even necessary?
I would have to say it depends on the situation that you're in. There are certain times that, yes, you do need it. Certain times where it's just an overkill. If you're out playing just regular rec ball with a bunch of kids and everything, no, come on. Really? No, you don't need it. If you're playing tournament style, speedball, stuff like that, I would have to say yeah, because then you are going to be with the other people. They're going to be doing the same thing. So, yeah, do it. J-Hub coming at you. Bye!
And we're back, still down here at Next Paintball, and the Cat Check is pretty much famous for a lot of our event reporting. We've been doing event reports across the U.S. and Canada, and we've got some pretty cool event reports from the U.S. On our board here recently, specifically the Greg Hastings Tour of Duty kickoff at the Old River Paintball in Florida. That would be the SBP scenario. Very cool event, right up courtesy of our very own Kelly Pistol Brennan. Also, we had a write-up on Blast Camp, the Battle for Hoth. It was an after-action report courtesy of Kelly and Matt Wickle, as they were in attendance for a very cool Star Wars-based event. Check that out on the Cat Check. And by the time that we are doing this, there will be an event report coming from Flag Raiders Red Dawn. Be sure to check that out on the Cat Check reports. It'll have a full-blown video and a lot of photos to check out. We do a lot of events across the country and across North America. Stay tuned. Cat Check reports paintball news. Storm Tomcat Cunningham with the Cat Check reports paintball news. And we'll see you guys on the field. Peace.
I'm Sean, the Undertaker holder, and we're here at Next Paintball in Canada Sports, and we're here with Team Bacchanal. We're going to shoot it up tonight, and you're watching Behind the Bunker.
All right, welcome back.
Awesome.
Okay, so, Dustin, we have probably a couple questions. Chris, you are out of tidbits.
I'm out of tidbits.
You're tidbitless?
I'm tidbitless.
Very good. Well, why don't we talk a little bit about tonight's subject, guys? Josh, I'm going to single you out first.
Tonight's topic...
That's because he didn't get a say in the last question.
For a couple weeks?
No.
Or was that something
we were talking about? How we wear our paintball.
Okay, sorry. Yeah.
Josh is at the show. He's just not in the show. So what do you think? Are fully automatic guns, three-round burst, or ramping even necessary in paintball? I know it's a broad question.
Absolutely necessary? No, I don't think any of it is. I think in certain situations, we play different types of paintball, it enhances the experience of paintball and possibly changes the game. But is 100% necessary? No. You know, we could all go back and still play the same paintball we're playing now with pumps. Or bolt action, as Snarky said. But, you know, having semi-auto ramping and PSP Millennium mode and all that does change the game a little bit.
Yeah. Now, we're watching our Twitter feed right now, guys. If you have an opinion, get it up there right now, and we will possibly get it on the air. Joe, what is your thoughts?
My thoughts? As you move into scenario and Milsim, three-round burst capability and fully auto could be used because it does add to the realism. I know in PSP and NPPL, they lowered rates of fire when the economy went down because fully sponsored teams were shooting so much paint, they dropped velocities. If they dropped, I mean, not velocity, they dropped
rate of fire.
Second, rate of fire, thank you, Dustin.
Misses
a second. But if they dropped it, just think, if they dropped it down even a little further to 10 balls per second, guys could go out using mechanical autocockers. They would use even less paint because they're so much more accurate. Just think about that.
I don't know. If you compare how...
You can pull 10 shots a second with an autococker.
I know, but the whole reason why an autococker gets the accuracy it does is because of the closed bolt. Because
guys know how to use it that are shooting it.
No, it's because of the closed bolt system. And if you look at something like a Lux or a Geo, they're all closed bolts anyways. As long as you can hold it steady... You know, at 10 balls a second, it's going to be just as accurate as an autococker will be.
Them's fighting words.
Hey, I have three autocockers, so it's not like I don't know them.
Going to sing the praises of the PCS PCS
US 5 is the greatest.
I think there is a place for it. Is it necessary all the time? I know a normal recreational Saturday and Sunday play, we don't allow full auto. We don't allow bursting. We don't allow ramping. We allow only slow semi if we're mixing our groups.
Yep,
so it's something to consider.
You know, I'm going to steal a little bit of what Wolf said because I definitely agree with what he says and a little bit of what Miss Beld said. I think all these modes have a time and a place. We're not talking... Okay, when you're playing with rental kids, I think that it all should be semi-auto. I think when you're playing a big game or scenario, I believe that all these modes are a necessity because you look at Modern Warfare and you have the guy with the semi-auto guns. You have the guys with the machine guns and you have the people who weren't running three-round bursts. What I disagree with is having the ability to have nerfs on your field, but that's another story.
Little sore about the rocket there, Todd.
Little sore about the rocket.
Todd doesn't like rockets. He got his ass nerfed in
Carolina. I did not prefer it. But that's a discussion for another time. But no, I think all the firing ones are necessary, and I think in speedball, I think it definitely changes the game, as Joe was saying, with speeds from 15 balls a second down to 10.5 or 12.5. I think all that is a necessity, depending on the game that you're playing. So I think it's great, and for those of you that don't like it, then don't play it. Play a mag fed or play a pump only or play, a non big game with an open walking class. So, yeah. And as far as nerf are concerned, well, let's not get into that because I will get upset. Scott from Key wants to know what is our favorite Girl Scout cookie flavors?
The mint ones, the chocolate covered ones.
I like the ones with the raspberry in the middle.
I like the vanilla ones, the white ones with the white stuff.
Where you get one sleeve of vanilla, one sleeve of chocolate.
No, I just like the vanilla. I like the white white with the vanilla. No, like this.
I like to take the chocolate Girl Scout cookie, take it in half and lick them. I like those. But the best selling Girl Scout cookies, apparently, I heard this just the other day, are the mint ones.
Yeah,
I'm not saying that's the best one.
You know what? When I was in Scouts, I got kicked out for eating brownies.
Oh.
All right, so why don't we move on? We have one more topic video, Matt, we're going to get to. And then as soon as we're done that, we're going to come back. We have many more videos. I still have two squirts I'd like to get to if there's time. We still have a video showcasing the new Z300 pump gun. And what is that? Well, stay tuned and find out a little bit more about it. We still have to talk about maybe the Duraline tanks that Joe, you found out about.
Yes.
We still have our friends at Scarab Arms that want to get their video on, as well as Skeletor. Wants to throw up a smoke screen. He was over at Sport Smoke. We have some new steel tanks that look like they're carbon fiber. We have the Valken pack to get to. We still have a gentleman who wants to show us a trick on how to load 10-round loader tubes. We have a plethora of videos to get to, and we're running out of time. So why don't we go to the Bowtie Bandits, and we'll come right back. And what time are we at? Yeah, we'll come right back after that.
Topic this week is, are enhanced firing modes even necessary? Such as full auto, ramping, and three-round burst.
I don't really think so. Typically, I just play semi anyway. And in a rec ball situation, if you sneak up behind somebody and have a three-round burst on, you can't just shoot them once. You pull that trigger, you're going to hit the guy three times. I think that's just a little excessive.
Personally, I like semi, but teach their own.
We're the Bowtie Bandits.
And you're watching Behind the Bunker.
All right. So I've got, as I mentioned, a list of videos to get to. Let's do a studio vote here. What should we get to watch next?
Are you going to tell us?
I just did.
Do you want to give options?
I just did just before we went.
Well,
I said
can't
we
be
have
doing that behind the scenes.
We have two squirts. I have a Z300 marker. I have a Duraline Scarab Arms.
I want
to
watch
the Z300 Snow.
I'm always one for squirts.
Z300 and Scarab Arms.
You don't even want to do those ones because you did them.
All right, tell you what. Why don't we check out Scarab Arms, and then we'll come back, and if there's time, we'll get to maybe one more selection. Chris gets overruled.
Hey guys, Todd Ansich here, back for Behind the Bunker. We are here live at Paintball Extravaganza 2013. I am in the Scarab Arms booth with my new friend Steven. Steven has some new stuff. For those of you that have never met Scarab Arms, they are a great new company that has a lot of MagFed things.
Yes, sir.
Tell me what you got.
What we have here is the TGR2. It's fully in production right now. It's a long rifle based, great cocking handle, MagFed marker. Proprietary to us are going to be our rounds and our mags. First strike equipped mags, you're looking at 18 regular rounds and you're looking at 16 first strikes. And in the near future, looking at third quarter, we have our own shaped projectile round. It's called the 1-to-1. Basically, it's going to be a foam injected 50 cal paintball, but it does fit in 0.68 markers. Same projectile, just a little bit less track metal at the end.
A little less stingy?
A little less stingy.
That's a patented word, by the way. Stingy. So very good. And what am I holding here?
You're looking at a CQB version of our TGR2. All these parts are going to be available in the near future. You're looking at July 2013. Just a shorter shroud, our own buffer tube. Same little doodads that you can get anywhere. Labco's going to make some barrels for us as well.
Good. That looks good on me, doesn't it?
It does.
Fits well.
It does.
So where do we find more information about Scarab Arms?
You go to our website, www.scarabarms.com, and check us out there.
That's on the internet, right?
Yes, on the internet.
Very nice. Check them out, guys.
All right. So well done. Chris, I'm going to put you on the spot. Anything in the Twitter feed that we need to get to?
Not a ton of stuff. Red Drew does make the comment. Personally, I would like 3-round burst because I manually do that already, and it would feel much more realistic. Is his comment
fair
on the subject?
Yeah. Good. No, that's a good point. All right, so why don't we get moving on here? We're going to go check out a video that Skeletor did for us at Extravaganza. This is Sportsboat. Check it out.
Hey guys, this is the Skeletor. I'm here with Sports Smoke, and let's talk to Matt and see what's new.
Hey guys, Matt here from Sports Smoke. Coming out from us, hopefully this summer, are new electronically ignited smoke grenades. These are actually available now, but we're going to be coming out with a remote fire kit that will allow you to detonate these from 300 yards away. You can set up special effects, ambushes, and it should be a real nice twist to the game. And of course, we also have our line of pull ring products, our TSG and our BFG. Cool burning, made in America, designed to be field safe, not shoot flames and sparks, and of course, the highest output of any grenade you're going to find in the States.
You heard it here, I'm behind the bunker! Woo!
Skeletor cool. Makes me smile.
He does. Yeah. Now we have, I have to be honest with you, I probably have 20 more videos from a Paintball Extravaganza that are products that you may or may not even know that exist. A lot of them are new products. We did play a lot of great ones on Thursday night this week, and you can go to our YouTube channel and see that it's up right now. There's been several thousand people that have watched it already, plus our live show, there's a few thousand people that's seen that, so I definitely think you need to go check it out if you've missed it. Great, great products.
Next year we're doing our Monday night show live from Extravaganza, and we will maybe even have some pre-release stuff.
That's right. So next year... Jack Wan's moving the camera around. Sorry about that, guys. So we're going to be there Monday night. We're going to do our regular Monday night show live from Paintball Extravaganza. And next year, we're going to try and get some snippets to be shown even before the show opens. So check that out. And then we're going to do our live show on Wednesday, actually from the trade show floor. instead of Thursday night after all the vendors go, we're going to do it a day earlier so you can get an even a quicker look. So check
now
that
Todd,
out.
Hey, Tank Chris. Wants to know in the chat, are the extravaganza videos going to be posted on our YouTube channel?
Yes, every video that we've posted on our show this past Thursday, as well as tonight, they're all going to be posted up as individual videos. Unfortunately, we got home late from extravaganza this week, and we had a big game this weekend, so we didn't get a lot of it done. So it'll be up probably starting tomorrow and Wednesday. I'll spend a couple days and put them up. So if there's any specific you're looking for, you can go back and watch it or share it with your friends. So check that out. Now, speaking of that, we have a few more videos from Extravaganza to get to. You guys wanted to see the Z300?
I like the color.
Squirts!
Z300? Yeah.
Why don't we watch the Z300? I'm not going to do the squirts, Chris, because it's a fairly long video and we're running out of time, and I do not want to get cut off. So let's check this out, guys. This is the new Z300.
Hey guys, Todd Hansich here back at the Empire JT booth for Extravaganza 2013. We are live. Now, guys, as you know, JT Splatmaster has the Z100 and the Z200. Great opportunities to get your youngsters into paintball. Low impact, fantastic, nice and safe product. But you know what, if you want something a little more to it, but still in the JT Splatmaster line, there is a new gun on the market. Can you tell us a little bit about this?
Yeah, this is the new Z300 Sniper from JT Splatmaster. It features a lever cocking action, holds 15 shots to load it, push the magazine release down, chop in your 15 balls, close it up. Features a top and bottom Picatinny rail, a collapsible, fully adjustable car stock, removable as well. It's got the slings in the back, you can sling it down in the front. Comes with a barrel plug, comes with a reusable target and a cleaning stick. These are going to retail for $49.95 and should be on the shelves beginning in May.
Cool. And the one thing I got to show you again is the cocking mechanism. This is so great if you've got a youngster who just doesn't have, you know, the muscle ability to cock these guns. With this here, you've got all the leverage in the world. Very easy to do. So if you know someone who you want to get into paintball, this is definitely a good opportunity. These are the JT Splatmaster guns.
All right, now I know most of you that are watching this program are turning up their nose at that and going, well, I would never shoot that. But you know what? This is not for you. This is for your son, your daughter, your niece, your nephew, or your friend that you want to get into paintball that's just too young and you want to give him a taste. Just a little taste. And that's all it's going to take. And this new gun, to be honest with you, I like the pistol and I like the shotgun. But why I like this one is because it has that side cocking mechanism on the side. And I know some small people that don't quite have the muscles
small
to pull
people?
That.
What do you mean small?
Small people, miniature people, young people.
Oh, not you. You've yes. crossed a politically correctest border.
That's behind the bunker, address 220.
Yes, the opinions reflect, yeah. So anyways, I think it's...
Are you endorsing it? I will send Mike Lowry an email and say Joe and Todd have officially endorsed the Splatmaster line, and we will get some for flag raiders to have for
I have
young,
six
young
cousins,
birthday
awesome.
Parties.
Yeah, for sure.
You heard it first.
All right, I'm getting Chris telling me that he would like to have some squirts. So why don't we go check out Colonel Mustard and his two squirts, and we'll be right back.
Welcome to Two Squirts. Today's topic is the Tippmann FT12. I was told it was originally designed as a rental marker due to its ease of maintenance, but it's available to you, the consumer, for around $130. It's a semi-automatic mechanical marker that I picked up to use as a backup when it rains or there's inclement weather. I don't trust myself with my electros when there's mud on the ground due to the fact that I slip, slide, fall, and run into things, so I picked up one of these because they're durable and they're easy to maintain. I've been using one for a couple of months now, but I recently had the opportunity to use it at a two-day scenario event at Adventure Beach Paintball because it was rainy, muddy, and humid the entire weekend. The build-out I used was an FT12 with a Proto Primo hopper. Now, these are gravity-fed, but if you don't know the Primos, they've got a shelf across the middle that keeps the balls from getting stacked up and jammed in the bottom, allows you to get a better feed. Use the J&J ceramic barrel on the front. This is a 14 inch. The good thing about these is if you get a barrel break, which I didn't all weekend, but if you do, you shoot about 5 or 6 balls and you're shooting straight through and you're back on target. You don't have to actually use a squeegee due to that coating. Now the FT12 did a great job. I've already cleaned it back up. It was pretty easy to break down and clean up. There's a lot of videos already out there showing how to maintain these. It's real simple, but check out YouTube. There's a bunch of them. I'm not going to go through it right now. As far as performance, air efficiency, I got 5.5 pods plus the hopper on a 4,000 PSI fill on a 68 cubic inch tank. Probably what you would expect from a mechanical marker. Not too bad. Across the chrono range, I was getting a 15 feet per second variance. Still not too bad at all. Pretty consistent. I didn't have much trouble shooting people out with it. I got a lot of gun battles with guns that were much more expensive than this marker, and I didn't have any real problems. I got a few questions over the weekend other than, Mustard, why are you using an FT12? I got a what is that? So if you haven't seen these yet, these did come out last year. They're a new marker. Check them out. But that's not the best question I got. The best question I got was, how does the Primo work with the marker? Because a lot of the times when you put one of these gravity-fed hoppers on a marker, you can outshoot the Primo. What I'm going to say is that the little bit of kick that the FT12 has must be just enough to jostle the hopper, because I never outshot the hopper. I did outshoot the gun. This marker, if you shoot it too quickly, it will not re-cock due to the fact that you're shooting it faster than the spring can return itself. So I did overshoot the marker a few times, but I didn't do it too much, and it wasn't that big of a problem because all you have to do is re-cock it and you're good to go. Overall, I'd have to say that it's a great marker for the price range. I don't think there's a better thing on the market. I'm just being honest, that's my opinion. But for $130, as easy as this is to maintain and as durable as it is, it's a good marker to pick up. The t-shirt you saw me wearing in this video is from
Electric Threads,
and it responds to music. What you couldn't see was my iPhone and music playing. That's what it was responding to the entire time. If you want to check these shirts out, check out
electricthreads.com.
I purchased this one just because I'm a fan of Epic Mealtime, but it says they do custom. I'd love to see some custom paintball shirts. Let me know if you do any. That's 2 squirts.
Fantastic. Electric Threads. Very cool.
No, hang on. I just got to say this before we go on. Sarah, if you don't know what Epic Mealtime is by now, come on out from underneath your rock. Get on YouTube, okay?
Sarah used to be here.
That was aggressive.
Get down here.
All right, guys.
Bottom of the bin.
So we're going to end it at this point. No, I don't have any more videos I want to play tonight. I want to sneak them into next week's show. They're too good to cram at the end of the show. I want to thank you guys for watching. Zuby, do you have anything you want to say as parting words?
Paintball around the world. Send your poster on in to show@behindthebunker.com. You can stop by the Facebook page, grab the logo off there, put it on your poster. We'll give you a little bit of extra love on the show.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Joe!
Custom Corner, if you have anything you've modified, tricked out, painted, done anything to, please send it to show@behindthebunker.com and we will get it on the show. Or if you have any shots of yourself playing paintball, send them to Action Shots. Pew,
pew, pew. Very nice.
Tell us where you are and who you are.
Now, if we had a cake and if we had candles, we'd actually do this properly. But I believe tonight, after one solid good show, Chris the intern has now been promoted to, from Chris the intern to Chris, our social marketing fellow.
Social media brand development strategist.
Yes, still head of tidbits. That up.
Can I like have an acronym on my business card?
I'll come up with an acronym for you later.
Have to.
Using my acronymial skills.
Chris, do you have anything you want to plug or ask for?
Well, given my new position, I will plug the social media, guys. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, including anything that was said on the show tonight, please mention it on Twitter, Facebook, or feel free to email us at show@behindthebunker.com. And thanks very much.
For sure.
Ah, awesome. Good.
Rocker in the chat forum is complaining that he is seeing a commercial right now because he's watching us live. Rocker, I know you can't hear this, but we are talking about you. So if this happens and you're seeing a commercial, watch us in Rewind. We're always on YouTube. So check us out. Go to our YouTube channel, subscribe, and you will get all of our updated videos. You're going to get all the videos from Paintball Extravaganza that we did last week, as well as any of the homegrown segments that we do, like such as From the Vault, Shit I Should Have Sold, and when Zuby starts doing his own
paintball
segment.
Paintball around the world. What is it going to be?
I don't know. We're waiting for Zuby to come up with an idea. If you have anything other than him reviewing plaid shirts, let him know, and maybe he can come up
I've
with
got a few.
I think I might wear a shirt, like a Zuby-type shirt next week.
And speaking of shirt, I've been waiting all day to
what
say this.
To wear?
We met a nice fellow. His name was Mike from Brazil, and he gave me this fantastic shirt, Mego Jago. You can see that. I don't know if you can see that well or not. Very nice fellow. He runs a very large game in Brazil, the biggest one there.
Biggest one. Yeah, biggest game in Brazil.
Yeah, very nice. He was in our studio audience on Thursday night for our live show. So I want to say, give a shout out. Thank you very much.
Michael.
Cool. So thank you to the guys in the production booth. Thank you to Dustin Schnitzelholz for asking the questions tonight. And if you have any, send them to the show at Behind the Bunker, and Dustin will ask that.
I'm running low.
He had a bit of a s out there, but I cut him off. Thanks, Matt, for pushing the buttons, as well as Chris, the intern, for being in our production booth. And thanks to you guys. We will see you back here next week for another fantastic edition of Behind the Bunker. Yeah. Thanks for watching, guys.